Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to World Championship Wrestling. Before we see Theodore Arlong's team of doom in action, let's hear what they had to say.
Road Warriors, you thought it was all over, but it just got started. Now, what I've got and done for myself is I've got two of the biggest, the toughest, the meanest guys in professional wrestling, and that's Doom. That's Soul Brother Butch and Soul Brother Run. Now, they're going to take care of the Road Warriors, and then after I'm finished with them, then Paul Ellering, I'm coming up to you, Sugar Ray Long. Now, let me say something to you, Paul Ellering. Right here, hold that up there for me, Run. And then, when I knock you out, I'm going to do this on your head, Paul Ellering. Just like that right there, baby. Because I'm the Soul Blaster with my Soul Brothers. Tell them about it, Big Butch.
Let me tell you something. Hulk Animal, you two skinheads. Let me tell you about it, boys. When y'all in the alleys having your little push and shove, little fights, we on the streets really rumbling and tumbling. And my brother Ron is going to be right with me doing the damage.
We are the masters of the alley. We are the streets.
The following tag team event, it is set for one fall. Introducing team number one in the ring, first from Portland, Oregon, weighing 255 pounds, Bill Lively. His tag team partner from Wilmington, North Carolina, 225 pounds, Brian Johnson. And their opponent, Theodore Arlong presents Hacksaw Butch Reed, Ron Simmons, the team of doom.
Dancing Teddy, or is he Sugar Ray Long?
Well, it all depends on what kind of mood he's in, Jim. When he's in a fun mood, he's Dancing Teddy Long. When he's in a fighting mood, he's Sugar Ray Long.
Well, I'll tell you something, he was in a talking mood just moments ago. They had a lot to say about the Road Warriors, and the Road Warriors have also made some comments, and we'll hear in just a few moments.
We didn't know what these two Road Warriors, they're coming for you. Doom is gonna kill the Legion of Doom.
Well, that was succinct enough, wasn't it?
No gray area there. Boy, they are massive, too. Look at that big stud. I'll tell you something. Oh, he's got a big mouth, doesn't he?
Yeah, but he's got a big everything else to back it up, too. And that's the thing that a lot of people can't stand, including a lot of these pig farmers out here, like he said, that are jealous of Ron Simmons and Butch Reed, and especially Theodore R. Dancing Teddy Long.
Fans holding up that Stinger shirt. We'll hear from Sting a little bit later in this broadcast, ladies and gentlemen. I know you kids especially are going to like what Stinger has to say to you.
Yeah, t-shirts are big with these people here in Altoona. They got pictures on them. You don't need to read them.
Brian Johnson tried to get the early advantage, but it didn't last very long as powerful Ron Simmons, who was a four-time football All-American, holy goodness gracious, at Florida State University. He was one of the most highly recruited high school athletes coming out of Warner Robins, Georgia. And he was a real plum that Coach Bobby Bowden picked out of Georgia to come to Florida State. But I don't think they're real proud of him in Tallahassee right now with this attitude.
They ought to be proud of him. He's the only thing that's ever come out of Tallahassee, Florida that got any fame or notoriety for himself.
Well, another noteworthy person that came out of Tallahassee, Florida is Missy Hyatt, who I'll be with tomorrow night at 6:05.
Only in your dreams, only in your dreams will that take place. Oh, you mean on the main event. I'm sorry.
Will you please get your mind out of the gutter?
Well, I'm just thinking about these street fight matches. When I think about street fights, I think about gutters and sewers. The Road Warriors, they were born in a sewer, they lived in a sewer, they're going to die in a sewer. They'll commit suicide when they get in the ring with Doom.
Well, Brian Johnson may want to contemplate suicide. And look at Theodore Arletti, Teddy Long there, all 140 pounds of him. But Simmons is about 280. Teddy Long, he thinks he weighs 340 pounds, not 140.
Well, you got to admire the man's guts. It's Brian Johnson. He's taking an awful lot of punishment at the hands of Doom. They're just kind of tuning up for what they're going to be doing to the Road Warriors.
lateral press, one, two, and they haven't had enough. They want to punish people. They want Hawk and Animal to know that they are going, they're doing this for them.
I want to see this Bill Lively get in the ring. He looks like a lively individual that I'd like to see get bounced around.
Double arm suplex by Hacksaw Butch Reed. These guys, they want a ghetto street fight with the Road Warriors. And I hear that next week we may see a ghetto street fight right here in the program.
Yeah, well, you know, the ghetto street fight is their kind of match. I'm not sure what the differences are since there's basically no rules in either one. But the ghetto street fight is what Ron Simmons and Butch Reed are masters of. The Chicago street fight is what the Road Warriors prefer. We'll see what either one's battling, Jim.
Fans, we are excited about our big date in the Meadowlands on Thursday night, April 26th, for you fans in the New York City area. Throughout the Northeast, tickets will go on sale this Monday at the Meadowlands box office, 9 a.m. this Monday. And here comes the lively one. Nice tan. That's not going to work. Reed is one of the toughest individuals I've ever been around. And Ron Simmons has that ability as well to take it to another level. They must be able to do that to survive, in my opinion, against the Legion of Doom.
Wait a minute, look at Lively. Lively is being lively here. What in the world?
Well, he was pretty lively for a few seconds.
I'll tell you what, this Lively, he looks like he went to give blood and forgot to say when.
Reed ramming the head of Lively right into the foot of Ron Simmons. They make the exchange there, tag made. Goodness gracious, what velocity. Double arm suplex.
Get a good look at his face. And this is how the Road Warrior is gonna look.
Get him off the road. Well, I don't know about that, big man. It's easier said than done, I'll tell you that. For all the great fans in New Jersey, New York, throughout that area, we hope you will take advantage of this information. The tickets will go on sale this Monday morning. The Meadowlands box office and all Ticketron outlets. And we get so much mail from the fans in New York, New Jersey, throughout that great area, asking when the NWA will be coming to your area. It will be on April 26th. The tickets go on sale this Monday morning. Right hand. Well, I'll tell you something. A lot of teams are intimidated physically by the Road Warriors. Doom is not. They match up very favorably with Hawk and Animal, physically, that is.
I'll tell you what I'd like to see. Besides Doom and the Road Warriors, I'd like to see Dancing Teddy, Sugar Ray Long, Ready Teddy Long, going up against Precious Paul Ellery in a street fight of their own. You know, Teddy's challenged him.
That wouldn't last long. Death. At least that's what I think.
No, Teddy's wiry.
Yeah. Uh-oh. Bill Lively isn't lively anymore. Boy, these guys are deadly.
Here are your winners. The team of Hacksaw Butch Reed, Ron Simmons, the team of Doom.
They will not stop these two big brutes. Here's another look.
Well, there you see it, Doom proving that Bill Lively was light and lively. Put him away for a victory. Chicago street fights with the Road Warriors are coming up.
And here's what the Legion of Doom had to say.
You know, back in the streets of Chicago, when we were little warriors, we used to get our butts kicked. But we always came back, and we always beat up the bullies until we became the bullies of the bullies. Now the tag team of the 90s is already gone. Skyscrapers, you're history. You're done. The team that ruled the 80s is here to rule the 90s and wrestling as long as we see fit. Tell them, Hawk.
Set up the Varsity Club? For what? So we can knock them down? Set up the Savoids? For what? So we can knock them down. Set up the Skyscrapers? For what? You got it. We knocked them down. Doom, stand up in line, boys. Just get in line. It's a short one. See, there's someone there, and then they're gone. They don't last long around here. Funny, why would that be? Maybe because of the Legion of Doom, the Road Warriors, and Paul Ellering? I think so.